So this wireless leak detection system is part of a larger research advisement lab, which is wireless sensing in general. But for this specific project, we are interested in finding very small leaks even before they start to cause any pressure drop.
So if you're in an aerospace structure up in space, it's pressurized, you have oxygen in it, so anyone in the structure can breathe. If, say, an object hits the structure and causes a hole in the structure, the pressurized oxygen is going to leak out.
Each sensor has four small sensors on it, and it measures angle of attack, which means angle of the signal from where it's coming from. So if you measure it at all four of those simultaneously, you can tell what angle the leak is coming from.
So we first start with the simulation, both on computer and with actual hardware. We generate a leak, add a bunch of statistical noise to it, and then make a bunch of guesses to where the leak is. Then we put it through an algorithm that we developed, and we say, this is most likely where the location for the leak is. And then we compare how close it was to the actual place.
The timeline is that by next year, we should have a prototype that is being tested here at UMaine, and we go for a test at Johnson Space Center. And then by the beginning of the second year, we'll have the device ready to be tested on the space. Once it goes up to space, the astronauts who live in the ISS, they will install it, turn it on, leave it there for a while, and then turn it off and ship it back to us. In the third year, we'll look at the device, analyze the data, figure out the strengths and the shortcomings of the device, and hopefully we'll propose a new design for the next generation.